today's video, I'm going to show you how you can take apart your E3 stepper motor so that you can clear away any clogs that might be preventing filament from loading. These can happen right here or right here and are sometimes invisible to the eye until you take the machine a little bit apart. You're going to need a screwdriver and possibly the Allen wrench that came with your 3D printer to take this apart. The first thing you want to do is unload your filament. It may or may not unload depending on the severity of the clog. Once you have the filament unloaded as much as possible, the first step you're going to do is remove these two screws here on the side so that we can take this whole piece and pull it out where we can get easier access to it. Be careful not to drop the screws into the printer. Once the screws are removed, you'll want to take the whole thing out. Now, it's gonna take a little bit of wiggling and finagling to remove it. It's a little awkward, but by removing it to here, we can now access the next three screws that we need to remove, which are here, here, and up here. As you're preparing to remove the third screw, be careful because there is a piece down at the bottom near that yellow arrow that may fall out when you pull this piece off. It lives right here and is sort of shaped like a top hat. Once the three screws are removed, you can simply pull off that front plate, and there is that top hat piece I was talking about. I'm just going to set it aside for the moment, but make sure you put it back if you do the same. I just don't want to lose it. You can also now take the filament tube and slide it out of the way. Depending on where your clog is, you may be able to simply use the unclogging tool or a paperclip or something to push the clog sort of through the gears from the top or the bottom, really any way you need to get the clogged bit of filament out from the middle here. If that does not work and you still have a clog here, you can, if it is in this top section up here, remove these two screws and that will pull this front piece off. If the clog is in the bottom part and the paperclip does not work to release it, you can use the Allen wrench to remove this screw here, and that will allow you easier access to the clogged parts. The only thing to know is if you remove this top section here, when you're putting it back together, there is a peg sort of right there that you have to slide in first before you can re-screw those back into place. I'm not going to show that in the video because most of the time you won't need to do that. And that part is pretty easy to disassemble and reassemble if you need to. Once you have your clog cleared, you need to put it all back together. So, take the filament tube and slide it up here. You can see there's sort of that gap that exists between the plastic and then the little slot that the tube sits in. And down at the bottom, don't forget to replace your top hat piece. Once you have them in place, take the front cover and slide it back over the entire stepper motor contraption, and then take the smaller screws, the three small screws, and put them back here, here, and here. The last step to reassembling this is getting it back in position. So again, you're going to go through the little wiggly wobbly process to try and get this back into position. It's always a little bit of a struggle, but what you're looking to do is line it back up with those same two screw spots that it was in at the beginning. It does sit at a little bit of an angle, so that is a correct position. And then you use the two remaining screws to re-secure it back into place. You are now ready to reload your filament. So, you can follow the loading video to show you how to do that. But in general, you just place the filament spool back where it belongs, feed it up until it is touching the stepper motors, and tell your printer to print. This should clear even the most complex jams that are happening here in the stepper motor itself. Thank you for watching.